Westminster is the home of British politics. Politicians meet here and make decisions that go on to affect all of our lives. So whether it's how much the minimum wage is, or whether friends or family are going to war, men and women meet here to talk about what's best for the country. But when I look around here, I don't see many people who are young. So it got me thinking, is politics just for old people? This week I'll be finding out what young people care about. Whether it's the recession and money, the threat of terrorism, or job availability. I'll also be talking to MPs about how they are getting young people to vote next year. I've come back to the studio to show you how many young people voted in the last general election 4 years ago. Back then, the UK's population was 60 million. Of that figure, less than half went out on election day to cast their vote. But the most important statistic of all, though, is that only 2.5 million young people voted in 2005. And that's why politicians want your vote. I received an email saying MPs are going on a whistle-stop tour trying to convince young people to vote. So I went along to see whether I could be convinced. It wasn't particularly inspiring. I really don't think that it's going to make people want to go out and vote next year. I went on my own tour to find out how teenagers feel about politics and politicians. I started off at a London college that has asked politicians why they should vote.
A good politician should be someone that's honest and someone who makes realistic goals.
They don't really understand everything that's going on. They just know the basics that they want to know about, but they don't know everything, like about crime and all this.
No, I think most of them lie. They like say they're going to do these things just to get points.
I think I've got a plan. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go undercover today. I'm going to find a group of young people, just basically ask what they're talking about, find out if they're talking about politics. I've tried to blend in as best I can. Got a bit of a beard. Can see, bit of a tash, so hopefully they don't recognise me. I'm trying to blend in with my t-shirt. Let's see what happens. Guys, what are you, can I ask what you're talking about? What's the topic of conversation at the moment? Are you talking about politics maybe?
No.
No, definitely not politics, right? What have you been talking about this lunchtime? Music. That's cool. Not politics then. You haven't been talking about politics this lunchtime.
No.
Have you been talking about politics?
No.
Yeah.
We're talking about how Nick Clegg's new foreign policy for the Lib Dems. And the shadow chancellor George Osborne about his expenses scandal.
This looks like a really deep conversation. I don't mind. Hope you don't mind me just intruding. What are you guys talking about? Can I ask? X Factor, alright, so really important. It looked for a moment like you might be talking about politics. No, not talking about politics. What were you guys talking about at lunch today?
What we had for lunch.
What you had for lunch, not politics today then. No?
We don't know that much.
Next time I'll be talking to politicians about young people. I'll also be designing and making the perfect politician. I've come to Westminster today to talk to MPs about how and why young people will be important at next year's election. I spoke to a member from each political party about how important young people will be next year. I also wanted to find out why we should be interested in politics in the first place.
Are politicians boring?
It can be, and they can be.
I think people who suddenly wake up one day at the age of 16 or 18 and say, I want to be an MP, I would find that quite unusual and probably a little bit unhealthy.
Well, I know from talking to young people in my constituency that they care hugely about political issues, but caring about those issues and, you know, going on petition marches and so on isn't enough. If you don't vote, then your voice won't be heard.
In a strange sort of way, when I was in Northern Ireland as Secretary of State, my aim was actually to make politics as boring as it possibly could be, because they had politics there in those days which involved people are killing each other.
I think it's important that young people who are entitled to vote should use their vote, but I think more importantly than that is that young people are engaged in the political process.
After speaking to politicians, I went to see a group of teenagers and got them to pick which candidate they would vote for based on their looks only.
His sort of demeanour is like dominating.
I would go for him because he's the youngest.
Yeah, he looks standing up straight.
He like looks as if he's like passionate about what he's saying.
I'd give this one because he looks like he's got quite a lot of experience and he's dressed all smart, ready for the job.
It was that one because he looks older, he looks like more experienced.
But this guy, he looks like he's doing something really important and not just like posing like the other two.
I picked this one as well because he looks like he's in the middle of doing something really important with the hand.
I then challenged the group to design their ideal Prime Minister. Each group had a specific body part to create where they would think about what would make the perfect leader.
Which is to sort of make him a part of the modern day culture. He's got a bullet hole wound there from war because he's a patriot and he served his country.
I gave him a gun because there's like no messing around, and we gave him a mum tattoo to show that he's a caring man and loves his family.
He's got a beer in his hand to show he isn't all serious.
Well, she's a woman and she's young, which means she'll be in touch with like young people. And
yeah, she wears Primark clothes because she's just down to earth, you know, they're cheap, fashionable clothing.
Wearing trousers don't fix in the session, it's, you know, getting them to.
He's got very smart shoes, they've got wheels on so he doesn't have to drive his car to work because he's eco-friendly.
So for the final and most important part of this project, I've come to a science lab where, using these blueprints that I've gathered, I'm going to try and make Britain's perfect politician. There we have it, Britain's ideal politician designed by the people. It may not be perfect, but whoever said politicians were perfect? But it seems young people don't mind.